Content is publicly sourced and used under the USA Fair Use and UK Fair Dealing Guidelines. The things I say are strictly my opinion. Good afternoon, everyone. It's the Busy Bee with the Royalty. It is the 17th of August. Happy Tuesday. Hope you're having a great day so far. I have some news to share with you today. The speechless Harry and Meghan can't keep their mouths shut. That sounds like the opposite of speechless. They're commenting on, just about everything. Afghanistan, the pandemic, the fragile state of the world, the earthquake in Haiti. My goodness, for people who are speechless, they sure run their mouths a lot. Here's my social media info. If you want to get in touch, always glad to hear from you. Here's how you can leave me a tip if you appreciate what I do. It helps me. It helps the channel. I appreciate it. Thank you in advance. All right, let's get into it. Before we get into it, though, I have a little funny story to tell you. I got a phone call on my cell phone today, and it sounded like a woman who was in her 70s. It sounded, like an older lady. And she asked for, I answered, I said, hello. She goes, hi, is R-A-C-I-S-T there? I go, what? She said, is R-A-C-I-S-T there? I said, ma'am, I don't know what you're talking about. And she said, well, is there a R-A-C-I-S-T there? I said, ma'am, no. I said, where do you get this from? I said, you have the wrong number. And I was thinking in my head, this is a really bad prank call. How did this person get my number? Because it was a local number. And then the lady goes, is this blank, blank, blank? And she actually read out my phone number. And I said, yes, it is, but you're sorely mistaken. I said, why would you call me and say this to me? You don't even know me. And she said, I don't know what you think I'm saying, but I'm saying, is R-A-Y-S-U-S there? Ray sus. I started giggling. I said, oh. I said, no, but you still have the wrong number, ma'am. I said, thank you for calling. Click. Anyway, so let's get into it. Speechless Meghan and Harry issue statement on the exceptionally fragile world. Meghan and Harry shared the statement on their website, Archewell, and urged people to put our values into action together. You know, they post their statements on their Archewell website because they don't want to go on Twitter or Facebook or something where people can come back and respond with the negative comments, because that would be all that they would get. Nobody has anything positive to say about these two. Meghan and Prince Ginge have released a statement commenting on how exceptionally fragile the world is right now. Oh, it just is right now. It hasn't always been fragile. There hasn't always been tension going on in the world. Please. The statement touches on the Taliban's rapid takeover of Afghanistan, the earthquake that hit Haiti, leaving over 1,200 people dead, and the continuing pandemic that has left them scared. Oh, they're scared. Poor Suxits. The Suxits, who are living in the U.S., also say that even though the events may leave people feeling powerless, people can put our values into action together. On their Archewell website, the home of all their post-royal projects, they write, the world is exceptionally fragile right now. You hear that? My dog hates the sound of Archewell. As we all feel the many layers of pain due to the situation in Afghanistan, we are left speechless. They're left speechless, but they're still talking. Amazing. As we all watch the growing humanitarian disaster in Haiti and the threat of it worsening after last weekend's earthquake, we are left heartbroken. They're left heartbroken, but what are they doing? Have they sent any cash over there to try to help? Any food? I'm sure they're not going hungry. And as we are all witnesses to the continuing global health crisis exacerbated by new variants and constant misinformation, we are left scared. When any person or community suffers, a piece of each of us does so with them, whether we realize it or not. And though we are not meant to live in a state of suffering, we, as a people, are being conditioned to accept it. It's easy to find ourselves feeling powerless, but we can put our values into action together. Hang on, now what did she just say? And though we are not meant to live in a state of suffering, Now, hang on just a second there. Suffering comes with existence on this planet, whether you like that fact or not. If you're a human being, you're going to face suffering in your life, whether financial or emotional or physical. Heck, you'll face all of them in your lifetime if you live long enough. So it's not really right to say that suffering isn't a state that we should have to live with. We shouldn't have to live with it constantly, but as human beings, we are going to have to face it and deal with it and get over it. Anyway, so in a call to action, they also urge people to support charity organizations doing critical work and plead with the international community to alleviate suffering. Here she goes again with the no suffering. And she's urging people to support charity organizations. I would love to see her spreadsheet, how much she's donated. The couple add, to start, we encourage you to join us in supporting a number of organizations doing critical work. To join us. Let me see, what have you actually done? Have you given your time? Have you given your money? No. We also urge those in positions of global influence to rapidly advance the humanitarian dialogues that are expected to take place this fall at multilateral gatherings such as the UN General Assembly and the G20 Leaders Summit. As an international community, it is the decisions we make now to alleviate suffering among those we know, and those we may never meet, that will prove our humanity. What has she done to alleviate suffering? Absolutely nothing. As well as a statement from Hare and Meg, the Archewell website also carries a statement from the Archewell team, which details how they are helping in light of these events. And I'm sure the statement was written by Meg. Okay. It says that we hope to do what we can to meet the moment by offering support to the military community and the troops who served in Afghanistan, as well as to the Afghan people facing violence and terror. The statement also adds that they are supporting the emergency response in Haiti with our partner, World Central Kitchen, which is working with local organizations that are helping with recovery efforts to save lives and preserve the health of those on the ground. And it adds that they are also working to support equity through our commitment to combating the spread of misinformation, as well as blah, blah, blah. The website lists organizations where people can find out more about the situations in Afghanistan and Haiti, including... Okay, last night Harry released another statement in his role as founder of the Invictus Games Foundation, in which he urged Army veterans of the Afghan conflict to help and offer support for one another. I'm so tired of reading this. This is such BS. They're out there saying, do this, help people, do like we do, give to the charities to support Afghanistan and Haiti. But what have they actually done? They haven't given any money that we know of. If they have, then let's see the figures. Let's see the receipts. And what they certainly haven't given their time, because if they'd been to a charity organization to do anything, they would have taken a photographer, so the pictures would be all over the place. Anyway, so that's it for Harry and Meg today. Thank you for watching. Please like, subscribe, comment, share, and I truly appreciate it. I'll see you guys in the next one. Have a good rest of your Tuesday. Bye.